So today we pressure washed the 67 Mustang hardtop. My biggest problem right now is our only water is right here, and our car is way over there. Hope I got enough hose.
You know those aren't gonna last, right?
Man, why you gotta be such a dream crusher?
I prefer to call it realism.
I think that using the aluminum duct tape will probably be better than anything else you could use. You could try doing
better than masking tape.
Masking tape's just gonna fly. Yeah. And duct tape probably not much better, but I'm hoping that the aluminum tape will actually keep me from getting too much water in the interior. We don't know what the cowls are like on this thing.
Yeah.
So we may be getting cowl, but I'm going to put the car cover to about right here on it so that we hopefully don't get anything underneath the car cover.
Cool.
But I must go and retrieve the pressure washer.
Good luck with that.
You haven't had your shower this week, have you?
This morning, actually.
Oh, yeah. God, because you could have had your shower for the week.
That's why I'm not covered in oil.
Pressure. I don't even want to know about that. To my little friend. I got to turn it on, but I always wanted to say that. I'm going to go and take a half hour to walk back to the other building and turn the water on. It's always something. No gas. No water. No oil. All of it's got oil. I hear it peeing. This doesn't mean the gaskets in the carburetor are dried out. Really don't want this to turn into a video on how to repair your pressure washer. Here. It's pretty daring. He probably needs a bath anyway. We should have put the cover on the car first. Let's let it run for a second and warm up. I wonder if I could change the oil and it would make a difference.
Probably not this time, right? I'm surprised it's not belching smoke. It's really loud, too. That's probably enough.
Weird that it sped up when it's supposed to be the slow spot, but that's okay. All right, let's get the car cover on it.
And it appears to be leaking engine oil now. On the front.
Uh-oh. Better work fast.
You got my side. You've got my side.
Huh? Okay, now we're pulling nice and tight.
Got it. Give me my side.
That was doing German tight knots.
CRC, heavy duty, pro strength degreaser, foaming all-purpose degreaser, water-based, and biodegradable formula. Oddly enough, this stuff works pretty darn well. Let's hope this can's not jacked. It got dropped on its head. It's kind of like me when I was a baby.
Stay. Figures. Now it won't start. Should have left it running.
My little friend! I'm not gonna shoot him. Always do this with your mouth closed. So much for the aluminum. I just blew one of them right off. Again, but it ran long enough. One got wet. Well, that's it. That's what I wanted to do. I wanted to get it pressure washed today. We've been doing a lot of big stuff. This is a little thing I wanted to get done, show you guys how we did it. That degreaser, the CRC stuff, I'd give it an A+. Engine bay prep by the guys in front of me, or behind me, D- or an F. Paint was flying up in chips. Big, ugly chips. And let's not talk about the dent in the shock tower from the power brake booster debacle. So I'm gonna tell you right now, this ain't mine. This belongs to this guy right here. Jeff Lambert is a good friend of mine from up in the York, Rock Hill, South Carolina area. Came down here and bought this frame out of Graniteville on apparently some small side street.
It was an alley, yeah. Shut down traffic for 2 days trying to get in there.
I'll get it in a minute. So he just drove over here to see us today, and I thought I'd put him on here because he's got some really cool stuff. He's got a product line called Greasy's Garage. Now tell me a little bit about Greasy's. What is Greasy all?
Greasy's Garage is, it started out as a kind of a made-up character around the shop, and we turned it into hand soaps. We have our pumice hand soap. Took us about a year to develop that, and we have a hand repair balm and a hand and tool wipe. So every time that we sell something off the website, we donate a flag for the veterans' graves. Nice. To the VFW,
yes.
The junior ROTC programs that go around for Veterans Day, Memorial Day, stuff like that.
Awesome.
So that's kind of one of our things that we like to do.
How do they find your stuff?
You can go to Greasy's Garage.
I'll put a link.
Trying to spell it.
He spells like most people in South Carolina. Yeah, would say myself as well.
Yeah. Greasy's Garage. Go to our website. Yeah.
Yeah. We'll put that down below. It will also be in the description below, so you can check out his stuff that he's got. He's also got a YouTube channel that he's kind of starting to work on.
Yeah, we're getting ready to start on it. Yep.
So he's going to be putting a YouTube channel up. He hasn't really got that together, so just keep checking back to Greasy's Garage, because he's theoretically going to be putting this 66 frame with his 64 F100. So kind of follow along with what he's doing over there. Check him out. Good dude. Nice fellow. So I just wanted to, he came in, so everybody that comes in here, if they show up, they got to be on film for at least a second. So here he is. This is his, I don't know, 15 minutes of fame on Autorestomod.
I feel famous.
And you look famous. So therefore, right?
That's right. We could just tell my wife I'm famous.
I'm sure she'll believe it. We have video of it.
We do. Can you tell me I'm always right too while we're at it? No?
Yeah,
no. I guess that's not going to happen. Okay.
Happen, I mean, yeah. Whoever is always right. Only one guy did that.
Right.
All right, man. Well, we'll let you get back on the road.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay. Yep. And come back and see us again. Maybe bring the truck or bring your car.
I'll drive the Model A up next
Model
time.
Model A needs to come back. Is this a flathead Model A? I've got a picture I'm going to put up here. That's the Model A. Really cool little car that he put together and did himself. So check it out. You guys have a great week. We'll see you later or whatever.